everybody.
Any question, you are free. You can
okay. You can write down Q&A slips if you want some, or you can raise your hand. Up to you. Okay, let's start. I'm Maddie.
So you said several times that it would be great to have one Asia, but also have your own Afghanistan policy in place rather than following communism or capitalism. Like, what alternative would you suggest that would also like be able to complete, not comply, but like match with other Asian countries as well?
The thing is that nowadays we don't have any extreme communism and extreme capitalists in this world. And also when I say that we should have our own regime or our own system, and every country they have different regimes, different situations. Yeah? In Russia there's another situation, in Afghanistan there's another situation. Basically, we should make, according to our culture, according to our values, our regime. When you make communist regime for an Islamic country, you will never accept it. When you make an Islamic regime for a capitalist country or for a communist country, they will not accept it. So in this case, the thing is that we should make our own regime based on our own culture, but we have to respect each other. There should not be any better culture in the world. There should not, there is no any better system in the world. Every system we can apply based on our own tradition, our own culture. That's why I'm thinking about this. In every country, we should make our system based on our own values, our traditional cultures, but we have to respect each other's culture and each other's system.
So then I wonder though, like the EU, the countries that are involved in that larger policy are like, I mean, they're different, but they're very similar. They have similar backgrounds and similar like values. And so with that, like they're able to make a more unifying policy. I think Asia is very diverse. And so like saying, oh, Korea, oh, India, oh, Russia, each of these countries are very, very different.
Yeah, actually, when you see to the Asia, the foundation of all civilization and all religion is Asia. The foundation of Confucianism, Buddhism, Hinduism, Islam, Christianism, all of them is Asia. So we have a very great civilization. In all civilization, we are focusing on humanity. The main core in Confucianism, Buddhism, Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, all of them is humanity. So in this case, we should think about our common things, not the things that are different. We should focus on humanity. We should promote this culture. Now in every civilization, we just put away our main, our core issue, our core value, that's humanity. We just catch the small things that we make differences from different regions, from different countries. So the only things that we should focus and we should promote, and we should do a great social campaign for the people, just in the common thing and the shared thing between every civilization in Asia, that's humanity, and we have to respect humanity, and we have to work on humanity, and based on humanity, we should promote our people.
You should create the World Asia policy based on the humanity. You
sure?
How about on the humanity? That's that was religious, politics, and your cultures, and many ideologies, communism and capitalism. But it is possible integration on the.
That's related to people. If they want, it's possible.
I think I agree with what he's saying. Like, it's a very romantic ideal. Like, let's focus on the similarity.
It's a romantic idea. But when we try, it's possible. That's related to us. If I say it's not possible, it's not possible. If you say it's not possible, it's not possible. Maybe I'm Muslim. Maybe you're Christian, Buddhist, or whatever. Yeah? But we have one shared value beside our religion. And we should focus on that. Why I should hate you, and why you should hate me? Because of culture, because of religion. If we want, it's possible. Everything is possible in this world. If the people want. If we think it's possible, it's possible. If we think it's not possible, it's not possible. And every country, in every situation, you're right. everything is possible, you're right. Everything is not possible, you're right. So in this case, we should make it possible. We should think positively. At least we can think positively. Can you?
Different races, very, very difficult problems, difficult races in Asia. It's possible, very, very different.
Everything is difficult.
Races.
Everything is difficult. Even if you think that just eating is also difficult.
I think this. I want to continue this. The question asked by the gentleman that, you know, how is it possible to, in Asia, especially a very diverse and in a very, you know, dynamic region in the world, full of culture, civilization, and how to go for like a European Union model in Asia. I think if we just respect diversity instead of, you know, cultural integrity or cultural uniformity. No, you know, and once I think if you go through the history 50 years back, I think Europe was the same. Like there were many cultural, ideological, political, and regional differences, even ethnic differences. There were war. But only the thing that can answer to this question, how can we integrate regional integrity or regional power like European, the trade and commerce. Because today we are more concerned about hunger, we are more concerned about poverty, we are more concerned about illiteracy, rather than the differences of culture, like religion, like sectarianism, like once Europe was on Catholic, Protestants, or you know, Orthodox, there were even worse sectarian wars in Europe then today what is going on in Asia. But having these diversities and differences, we can integrate, like even like ASEAN today. In ASEAN, I think there is free visa movement. So in ASEAN countries, there are different, like Indonesia and Malaysia, they are Christian, Muslim countries. Like, you know, Philippines, they are mostly Christians. Like Vietnam, it's a communist. So still they are integrating, they have at least one point, some agenda point, that is, you know, how to get rid of poverty, how to get rid of hunger, how to grow financially, economy. So it is only trade, commerce, economy that can force the people. The same model can be applied. Diversity should be there.
Yeah.
Differences of, because it's something biological, it's something very psychological. Suppose I live in Pakistan, I have my own ethnic group. I'm never ready to finish my ethnicity, my language, my subcultural entities. But I live in equality, but with my diversity, not leaving my diversity. In Asia, you can say different religions, different civilization, different political and economic ideologies. We can carry on, but still, human being, if we consider humanity, I know your idea is very much romantic, it seems very ideal, but still, there is a chance. If Europe could prove it by shunning, by finishing all the sectarian differences, religious differences, ideological differences. Look, if even the Germany and UK, how much they hated each other. France and UK, how much they hated each other. But today, they are just like...
Sorry. I don't want to cut you off, but unless you have a specific question, maybe...
I'm just, you know, continuing that discussion.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was actually not a question.
Yeah.
So this is my idea. Living in diversity is possible. Not
yeah,
possible.
When,
yes.
when I said that you should respect the different culture, that means you should respect diversity. Why do I have different culture? Because there's diversity. Polish people, they have their own culture. In Afghanistan, they have their own culture. Korean people, they have their own culture. So when we respect diversity, when we respect the people, regardless their skin, their color of their body, and their values, when we respect each other, when we respect the diversity, it will be possible.
So is that respect coming from a state of equilibrium, though? Like, okay, yes, a long time ago, Europe definitely had crazy wars, but we're in a state of, or not we, I'm American, I'm not European, but like Europe seems to be in a state of moderate equilibrium where, you know, there's communication channels. Here in Asia, it seems like it's, to me, it's too different. Yes, diversity is great, but how can you communicate if there's no channel for that?
You make it.
How?
As I said, when we can think of things as possible, so when we get together, when we try from today with this small population, I'm sure 2 days later there will be more than 200. Some days later more than 100, 500, 10,000, and again, we can do it. If you could do it, we can do it. If Germany, they could destroy the Berlin Wall, the South Korea and North Korea also can destroy that the wall between these two countries. It doesn't mean that we cannot be in Asia, we can do. It doesn't mean that the civilization and going forward just for Europe and USA and America. We can do. The thing is that we are going to undervalue ourselves. When we do not undervalue ourselves, when we think just there's the USA people, the American people and also European people, they don't have anything better from us. We can play. Everything knows the civilization, development is for Europe and for Asia is the same. In middle age, so in Middle East, it was my developed country. It was the foundation of mathematics. It's the foundation of too many different sciences. But at that time, Europe was in darkness. If we could go back and we make alive our own values, our past values, we can do it. If you could do it, we can do it.
Wait. all right. We had Shahed over here, so I'll go with Shahed first, and then last question. Okay. So one and two.
Anyway, actually, I just want to make some comment and question. What he thought, what he said, it was being discussed 100 years before. Before the European Union, before the African Union, there is a one Asia initiative. It is from Japan. I forget his name, some might be knowing. It is 20th century. And he was a very good friend of our poet. He was the first Nobel laureate in literature in Asia, Rabindranath Tagore. When Tagore visited in Japan in 1909, at the time he met, they were very good friends, and that man had a vision, One Asia Initiative. So it is not a European idea. And before European Union, before African Union, someone in Asia already thought, this man is from Japan, to make One Asia. So it is not impossible. Actually, I think my observation is, not only the superpower, like communism, capitalism, but of course there are very good things in capitalism, not all are not bad. Democracy is not a bad thing.
Yeah,
but there is a good things, whatever we can accept, and at the same time, what we have, it's possible to make a One Asia, and so that we can be more stronger, so that this superpower, they cannot fight their war in our land. That they bring.
Yeah.
So actually destroying ourselves, our people. So I very much agree with you, and that could be an initiative. But one thing I'm very much concerned that the Europe and Africa, especially Europe and America, they already solved this problem. That problem is religion. I think the religion should be in the personal level, not in the state.
Yeah.
While you make the religion in the state level, it makes some differences, some problem. And they are using Western power, multinational corporations, state, bad, evil power. They are using the religion as weapon to make the debate and to grab our resources and to fight their war in our land. Thank you.
The thing is that I'm always saying the people they are doing politics, they are not honest. And the people they are honest, they are not doing politics. Yeah, I know what is going on, but still I'm afraid of politics. Am I involved in politics? If he knows everything about Pakistan, if he's involved in politics, you are from Bangladesh, you know everything, then you're involved in politics, and that time we can be a good brother. And then at least, we do not involve politics. So, personally, you're a good friend. But politically, I hate Pakistan. Because I know what the Pakistan did in my country. So actually, they should involve the people that they know, they should involve in politics, they should do politics honestly. And that time is possible.
Okay, and yes, we'll take the last question.
Yeah, you mentioned about the integration of Asian country. I think the possibility of such a thing that, as many of audience mentioned about diversity, because it's a very severe, serious diversity in Asia, I think the possibility of such a thing would be, or integration of Asia would be possible if you start working from now, maybe 100 years or 500 years later, if you work from now, something like that, for integration of Asia. But what do you think if we, about making a block, like countries that they have some similarities, that they share some similar culture, and like Japan, China, and Korea, and North Korea, they make a block, and some other countries like India and Nepal, when they make some other block, how do you think about an alternative of block rather than a single integration of Asia?
Actually, making block, it can be a foundation for making Indonesia. If you make it possible to make block, if it's possible to make block between Pakistan, India, and Nepal, I'm sure they will be possible to make one.
I think we have SAR and
so it's just as a name.
Yeah.
It's just as a name, but we have to work on it to make it reality. The thing is that one of the country in America, Canada, is very diverse in country. The people from Iran, Afghanistan, even the Prime Minister of Canada, he is going to celebrate Nowruz with the Iranian and Afghan people. He's going to celebrate the holy with Indian people because diversity. If they can do, we can do. Again, I'm telling you, if they could do, we can do.
Okay,
thank
you. And I'm going to take the privilege to ask the last question, actually.
Okay.
I tricked you. Yeah, myself being from the US and also being from Russia, I have the double superpower evil going on here. So we're talking about what Asian countries can do, but what about what we can do? We people from those superpower countries, how can we pressure our government and our society to wake up and stop fighting proxy wars somewhere else? And because it, in fact, it's not in our best interest either, right? Like, our governments go and fight wars with other countries, but it doesn't help the people in the USA either. It doesn't help the people in Russia. So it doesn't help anyone. So what can we do as citizens of those countries? How can we help this?
You have to fight against your country by your power. There was one soldier from USA that he spent 5 years in Afghanistan. When he went back, he had a speech for the American people that he told, that's a crazy thing that we are going to fight in Afghanistan and kill the people because of this Eric politician. And he told that we have to fight against this Eric politician, and we have to aware the people that the fight, that the war that we directed in Afghanistan is not good things. So you can fight against your government, against those politicians that they are light the fire of war in other countries. They are doing their war in other developing nations, and that time it's possible because you are much democratic than our countries. When you claim democracy, you should make it possible.
But it's less democratic than you think. It seems that way on the surface, but once you start to go in, it's a lot less freedom.
People ask how election works.
Yeah, the election system in the US is not democratic at all, so. But anyway, yes, thank you so much. Okay,